Because of the CBS News special report which follows, Mayberry RFD will not be presented tonight, but will return next week at its regularly scheduled time over most of these stations. The Draft Lottery, a live report on tonight's picking of the birth dates for the draft. Here at Selective Service Headquarters in Washington is CBS News correspondent Roger Mudd.
Good evening. It was 29 years ago that the first and most famous lottery number, 158, was drawn as the United States entered World War II. Tonight, for the first time in 27 years, the United States has again started a draft lottery. And the famous first pick tonight is September 14th, the first birthday that now is designated 001, which means for 19-year-olds born on September 14th, that beginning in January, local draft boards will induct those men born on September 14th, barring deferments. The next birthday in order, April 24th, and so on down the line this evening. This ceremony, which began at 8 o'clock, is now more than two-thirds through. There are 366 numbers to select, one for each birthday in the year, plus one for February 29th, the leap year. The ceremonies began at 8 o'clock under a bill signed just last week by President Nixon.
October 27.
It had been the president's plan to fly in from all over the country members of his Selective Service Youth Advisory Council, with one member from each state picking five or six capsules from this big glass bowl. But at the last minute, the ranking Republican on the House Armed Services Committee, Alexander Perney of New York, apparently was invited to select the first number. So Mr. Paul Murray, the student from Rhode Island, followed Congressman Perney. The ceremonies this evening here at the Selective Service Headquarters were much less elaborate than those in 1940. Of course, these are geared to television, but 29 years ago, for instance, Secretary of War Henry Stimson was blindfolded with a swatch of upholstery that had been clipped from one of the chairs used at the signing of the Declaration of Independence. But there was a constant between then and now, and the constant is General Louis Hershey, who was then the draft's executive director and who tonight opened the ceremonies as the outgoing director.
Pursuant to the executive order, the Director of Selective Service is going to establish tonight a random selection sequence for induction for 1970. I will ask Congressman Perney to come forward. Congressman Perney is representing the United States, the Military Affairs Committee of the House, and he also is a senior Republican president who has been the watchdog committee of this selective service system. And we're going to ask him to choose the first.
September 14th.
September 14-001.
Mr. Paul M. Murray, Rhode Island.
April 24th.
April 24 is 002.
December 30th.
December 30, 003.
February 14th.
February 14 is 004.
And here's the Norelco Santa with some new ways to say Merry Christmas. Give the Norelco triple header with a cord or in a rechargeable model. Give the inexpensive Flip Top 20 or the new battery cordless. And say Merry Christmas to the ladies with a Lady Norelco shaver or beauty salon. Norelco, even our name says Merry Christmas.
February 29th.
This evening, this has been a very systematic, almost mechanical lottery, the first really nationally televised lottery we've ever had. There's been little excitement here, but for one or two brief occasions, four or five of the Youth Advisory Council members declined to participate, claiming that they thought they were being used by the Nixon administration to give a youth approval to the lottery system. The representative from the District of Columbia stepped up to the microphone and said he was refusing to participate. The young man from Indiana got up and said while he approved of the lottery, it was not an end in itself and that he hoped for an even better system than this. The main information we have this evening, of course, is the order of the birthdays. And those will determine how the 19-year-olds next year, those from 19 to 26 will be subject to the draft. So let's go down the list and give you the ascending order in which they were drawn tonight. We'll take them in blocks of five, from the lowest number up to the highest. September 14th, April 24th, December 30th, February 14th, October 18th, September 6th, October 26th, September 7th, November 22nd, December 6th, August 31st, December 7th, July 8th, April 11th, July 12th, December 29th, January 15th. This is ascending order. Each man posts them as they are given to him. Number 18 is September 26th, November 1st, June 4th, August 10th, June 26th, July 24th, October 5th, February 19th, December 14th, July 21st, June 5th, March 2nd, March 31st, May 24th, April 1st, March 17th, November 2nd. These are in ascending order. It is generally agreed, stipulated by the Selective Service people, that those men with the lowest numbers, the lowest third, will be drafted. So for number 35, it is May 7th. August 24th, May 11th, October 30th, December 11th, May 13th, December 10th, July 13th, December 9th, August 16th, August 2nd, November 11th, November 27th, August 8th, September 3rd, July 7th, November 7th. The middle group, that is the group with the numbers between about 120 and 240, stand about a 50-50 chance of being drafted next year. Number 52 is January 25th, December 22nd, August 5th, May 16th, December 5th, February 23rd, January 19th, January 24th, June 21st, August 29th, April 21st, September 20th, June 27th, May 10th, November 12th, July 25th, February 12th. The highest ranking numbers, that is from about 240 to 366, apparently, from all the Selective Service says, will probably not be drafted in 1970. Of course, there will be another call in perhaps November of next year. Number 69 in the most liable group, June 13th, December 21st, September 10th, October 12th, June 17th, April 27th, May 19th, November 6th, January 28th, December 27th, October 3rd.